Hello friends, this is Mr. P.S. Bidkar, Assistant Professor at Sanjay Gadhwal University, Kolhapur. Today we are going to see about the silicon control rectifier. In my previous video, we have discussed about the structure and symbols of SCR and their applications. Now we are going to study how to start the SCR and VI characteristics of SCR. Now this is the circuit in which we can plot the VI characteristics of SCR. So now if anode is connected to positive, cathode is connected to negative through some load like RL, and gate is having positive voltage, then we can turn on the SCR. Initially what we do, we are going to apply anode positive, cathode negative, that is VAK. So the forward voltage is called as anode to cathode voltage, VAK, and if we are trying to increase VAK to a sufficiently large value, then without applying gate voltage, your SCR will break down. So this voltage is called as forward breakover voltage, that can be seen in the structure also. Now you can see, if I apply positive anode, negative cathode, then junction J1, junction J3 will get forward bias, but junction J2 will get reverse bias. Now to forward bias junction J2, you have to apply gate current, but in first case I have not applied any gate current, so junction J1, junction J3, they are forward bias and junction J2 will break down. So without applying the gate current, if you apply sufficiently large VAK and your SCR conducts, that voltage is called as forward breaker voltage. In this condition, SCR will break down and it may permanently damage because of breakdown of junction J2. Now how to turn on the SCR in normal case? Now in case of normal case, you have to apply VAK, that is anode to cathode voltage, anode positive, cathode negative, and you have to apply gate current. After application of gate current, junction J2 will get forward bias. Now you can see, already junction J1 is forward bias, junction J3 is forward bias, now junction J2 is forward bias by applying positive gate current, and current will flow from anode to cathode. So this is the normal operation of SCR that can be seen in this characteristics also. Now you can see the dotted line indicates the application of gate current. After application of gate current, voltage across SCR will suddenly drop down. So normally the voltage across SCR will drop to value equal to 1 volt or less than that of 1 volt. Now what is IL? So IL is called as latching current. Latching current is defined as, it is the minimum current required to turn on the SCR. So you must have IL value to turn on the SCR. Now what is IH? Once the SCR is turned on, you have to maintain minimum current equal to IH, that is called as holding current. H stands for holding current. So this is the minimum current required to hold the SCR in on state. Now this line indicates that as you go on increasing the VAK, voltage across SCR or turn on voltage across SCR will remain almost same, that is equal to 1 volt. Now this voltage is called as forward voltage drop. So it is approximately equal to 1 or less than that of 1 volt. Now what is reverse breakdown voltage? Now you can see, if I am going for reverse way, if I apply anode negative, cathode positive, and if I increase this voltage to sufficiently large value, what will happen? My SCR will break down. That can be seen from, once again, from structure. So if I apply anode negative, cathode positive, junction J1 and junction J3 is reverse bias and junction J2 is forward bias. So if I apply sufficiently large voltage, junction J1 and junction J3 will break down and your SCR will conduct. Current will flow from cathode to anode and this will damage the SCR permanently. So this is not the normal operation of SCR. So this voltage is called as reverse breakover or breakdown voltage. Now you can see the different values of IG. So if I apply more VAK, I require less gate current to turn on the SCR and vice versa. So these are the VI characteristics of SCR. Thank you.